If you're looking for affordable and easy-to-use audio editing software for PC, Magix SoundForge Audio Studio 14 might be a great choice for you. In this SoundForge tutorial, I'm going to go over recording, editing, and using some of the effects that come with SoundForge Audio Studio 14, including iZotope Ozone Elements 9. I'm Zane from AudioTechTV.com, and on this channel, I do weekly audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you conquer the tech and unleash your creativity. I've included a link in the description to Magix website so you can easily hop over there and download the demo, or of course you can purchase it too if you like. Now let's get into this tutorial. So first up, I'm going to change the default layout. I like the podcast layout as it uses more of the screen for the waveform and it gives us some more meters at the bottom. You also get a markers list, which I'll get into in a little bit. So go up to View, then go to Windows Layouts, and you can change it to Podcast. There's also some other layouts here. See which one fits your workflow best, but I'm going to choose Podcast. And here's the markers list right here. I just like this layout a lot more. This step isn't necessary, but this is the view that I'm going to be working in, so I just wanted to show you how I got it to look this way. So let's do some audio recording. Go up to File, click on New, and now you have some options here. And the sample rate of 48,000 is typical for video work, and same with 24-bit. 44,100 and 16-bit is CD quality, so you can choose the quality that you want here based on whatever it is you're going to be recording. A microphone is just a mono source, so I'm going to keep this as mono, and then click OK. Now let's just quickly check out our audio settings to make sure our interface or USB mic is the one that's selected for recording. So go up to Options, Preferences, and then in the Audio tab, go over to Record, and you'll be able to see your device listed in here. And for Channel 1, you'll want to make sure it's set for the input 1 or 2 or your microphone, whatever it is you're going to be recording, you want that to be on channel 1 right there. And you may have to change the audio device here. It could be set for something different than what you're going to be using. I'm using my USB mic, which is the Shure MV51, and that's set to channel 1 here. Once you have that set up, you can click OK. And now just one more quick step before we start recording. Go up to View, and then click on Recording Options. It's right here. Now you can turn your monitor on or off. So if you have monitoring on, you'll be able to hear yourself while you're recording. If you turn it off, you won't hear yourself while recording. And of course, that depends if you're wearing headphones or you have speakers connected. But I personally like to keep it off when I'm recording my voice like this, so I'm going to leave it off. Also, if you want to check your levels, you can do that in here as well. Just click the Arm for Recording button right here. And now you'll see your levels down here. So it looks like my levels are okay, and I can start recording. You can actually leave this open if you like, if you prefer these meters here. And again, it's all just a preference thing. And now we can hit Record. This is a demo recording in SoundForge Audio Studio 14. If you're enjoying this video so far, please give it a thumbs up. Now that we have our audio clip, we can do some editing. So go up to this area right here and click on this icon for the event tool. And now we can edit the audio with this. So we can come down here and go to our clip and say we want to make a split right here. Click there. And then you can just press the S key on your computer keyboard, or you can right click and click on split. And now these two parts are separate from each other. So I can actually drag this over, or I can drag it this way and you'll see the crossfade happening here. Or I can even extend this and copy this part over here and I'll have it two times for whatever reason I might want to do that. Also, you notice if I hover the mouse in the top corner here, it changes. If I click and drag, I can create a fade at the beginning of this part of the clip. And you can do that on the other side of the clip as well. You can trim the clip by just hovering over the edge of it, clicking and dragging either way. You can do that on both sides of it. If when you're recording you make a mistake or there's a part that you might want to revisit, you can actually just press the M key on your computer keyboard, and you can see it makes a marker right here. And you can do this while you're recording. So let's have a look at that right now. I'll start recording again. This is a test of making markers. Here I am pressing M, and there's another marker showing up. I'll press it again. You can see down in this list here, we have three markers. And you can actually rename these if you like. And if you click over here, it jumps the cursor to that marker. And you can play from that marker by clicking the play button on each one. And this is very helpful if you're recording your podcast and you know there's a part that you kind of flubbed, or you know you want to revisit it for whatever reason. You just hit that M button while you're recording, and then you can go back and easily find it. Or it's also great if you have different sections of your podcast or whatever it is you're recording. You can just hit that marker and you know, okay, that's where I'm going to put in my bumper or my intro or whatever it is that you want to put in there. Which brings me to, what if we need to bring other audio in? There are different ways that you might want to do this. You might want to bring a music bed to go underneath your voice, or you may want to splice in another piece of audio like a podcast intro or a bumper. You can do both of these in SoundForge Audio Studio. First, let's look at adding some music under our voice. So you can actually drag and drop an audio file into SoundForge from down in this area here. And that's what I'm going to do because I can see I have some audio files here. So just drag and drop it up here. The other way to do it is you can just drag and drop it from either your desktop or a folder on your computer. You would just drag it in, hover over, and drop it in there like that. So let's switch over to the tab of the audio that I just brought in. So you can either choose this entire clip by pressing Control A on your computer keyboard if you want to bring everything over, or you can just highlight a section that you might want to bring in. And then you just press Control C on your computer keyboard to copy, or you could right click, copy. And we'll go back to the tab of what we recorded earlier. Now let's say I just want to put this music under the intro part of my voice here. So go to wherever it is you want this audio to start. And then you can just press Control M on your computer keyboard, and you can see it brings up this mix slash replace window. And you have two faders here. The first one is for what you're pasting in, and the second one is for what you've already recorded. So you want to bring the music bed down so it's underneath your voice, and you can preview it as you go. This is a demo recording in SoundForge Audio Studio 14. If you're enjoying this video so far, please give it a thumbs up. All right, let's say that's what I want. Click OK. And now, this is a demo recording. That's what we have. So that's one way of adding other audio into your clip. The other way would be copy this audio from another clip and then go back here. And we made our slice here, so we'll move this over. Then we can go back to our edit tool and right click paste. And now you can see we have this whole other piece of audio in here. So we could drag this and do some crossfading with it if we wanted that to be in the middle and then crossfade on each side. So maybe it's a song you want to play in your podcast. So you want your voice to fade out while you're going into it and then fade back in when you're coming out of the song or whatever it is that you're going into and out of. This is very easy to do. All right, now let's look at using effects. You can use effects on your entire audio track or just on sections of it. If you just want to put an effect on a section of your audio, go over to the edit tool here. Then you want to click and highlight the section that you want the effect on. And then you would go up to effects or effects favorites and add the effect that you want. So we'll try it out here. We'll go up to effects and say we want to add some reverb to this section here. We'll just choose one of these presets, say Dream Verb. Let's listen to what that will sound like. Is a demo recording in SoundForge Audio. All right, let's say that's what I wanted. Just click OK.
This is a demo recording in SoundForge Audio Studio 14. If you're enjoying this.
And you can hear just that section had the effect on it. Now, if you wanted to put an effect on your entire track, Just press Ctrl-A on your computer keyboard and that selects everything. And this time we're going to go up and use a third-party plugin. And you can see if you click on Effects Favorites, all of these plugins are in here. These are all third-party plugins that I added. If you don't see any in here and you know you have third-party plugins installed on your computer, go into Options, Preferences, VST Effects tab, and then make sure in here your default VST search folder is set to whatever folder you use for your VSTs. And then once you set it, you click OK, it's going to scan for them, and you should see them up in your Effects Favorites. If you don't see them in here, in this list here, you may have to go into Organize, and you can go in here and right-click and add to Effects Favorites individually. So I'll just test out this Waves Berserk Distortion plugin. Let's hear what that will sound like.
This is a demo recording in SoundForge Audio Studio 14. If you're enjoying this video so far, please give it...
All right, say that's what I wanted. Click OK. And we have a third-party effect on there.
This is a demo recording in SoundForge Audio Studio 14.
Now let's quickly look at iZotope Ozone Elements 9, which is a great plugin that you get with SoundForge Audio Studio 14. So just like before, select the area that you want to affect, go up to Effects Favorites, then iZotope Inc., and you would find Ozone 9 Elements. And you'll see that you can access some presets in here just by clicking Presets, and it brings up this window. Or you can use the Master Assistant, which will kind of do everything for you. So click on Master Assistant, then you can click on the intensity that you want. I'll just leave it at medium. If you're just going to be streaming, click Streaming. If this audio is for CD, click CD. Then click Next. And when you're on this screen, you want to hit the Preview button.
This is a demo recording in SoundForge Audio Studio 14. If you're enjoying this video so far, please give it
a thumbs up. This is a demo recording in SoundForge Audio Studio 14. If you're... All right, let's listen to that. This is a demo recording in SoundForge Audio Studio 14. If you're enjoying this video so far, please give it a thumbs up. And you can make any adjustments you want in here, or you can accept it as is. Click OK, and you'll see it's made those automatic edits for you. Now you'll have to play with that effect a little bit. Sometimes the auto mastering doesn't quite get it right every time, but it does give you a good starting point and you can adjust as needed. Be sure to try it out on your next podcast and see if it can add a little magic to your voice. Click here to check out 30 free VST plugins, or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you'll be interested in next. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.